I'm going to, we're going to be sitting up here, so I'm going to move the podium. That's where I'm coming. Okay.
Here, wait. Look at it.
All right.
He'll carry it himself.
Is this connected? Now, your mics, how's your mics?
We're tied into the podium there.
You tied in, everybody's tied into the podium?
Yes.
Would you prefer that we use the podium?
Yes, please.
Okay, all right then, all right. Okay. So we're going to use podium?
Okay.
Okay. All right. Is this somebody's? Is it? It is, okay. I should say that, Mr. Everson. All right, is everybody ready? Okay. Well, thanks for coming by for this. As you know, Sherwin-Williams has issued a press release saying that they've made their decision, and their decision is to locate their headquarters in downtown Cleveland and their research facility in Brecksville. We have been having a discussion for how long now?
I think it started end of August, beginning of September.
Of last year, August, September last year, on a pretty tight time schedule, as we all parties were really heavily involved and intensely involved in coming up with what we believed and what they believed would be a fair and equitable package that would allow for them to make this decision. So let me say that we're happy that they made the decision, their decision to locate research in Brecksville in the headquarters here was based on what they felt was in their corporate best interest. We're happy that they're staying in Cleveland as a headquarters over 150 years as a citizen of the city of Cleveland. And with the building of the headquarters, new headquarters, we anticipate that that will be, that 150 years will be decades longer. They've also, in their press release, indicated that they've, that we're not quite final in terms of the details of our development agreement with them. So that, so being very specific about dollar amounts and things like that, we will not be able to do today, but we'll do very quickly because we're pretty close to tying up these loose ends. And as we tie up these loose ends and we then put that in legislative form that will have the specifics of it, then we'll send that over to council and you'll be aware of it. The reason why we do not have legislation now to introduce on Monday is because we still have some loose ends that we have to tie up that are very specific in terms of development agreement, the various incentives. I can give you the category of the incentives. It is a non-school TIF, the job incentive grant, and then what is the third bucket?
Financing for construction.
And the financing for construction, which is a combination of grants and other kinds of tools. The economic development director can better tell you what those tools are and how they work. So again, we're pleased with this outcome. We look forward to working with them going forward, and we look forward to finalizing this, tying up the loose ends, putting it in legislative form, and then sending it over to council. Now we have, I have been talking to the council president over this period of time in a broad, high-level approach, because as you know, we were not in these kind of things, you don't negotiate in public, and so we did not have the specific things to give to the council president because we had not reached any specific agreement with Sherwin-Williams. But we did keep him apprised at council leadership. And I think as late as today that the two of you have briefed the council president again on the buckets of, of the financial incentives and some details without giving them everything because we haven't tied it all up yet. But we do plan to have a legislative agenda that we will present to council. The council president is here, and he will then it will be in his world then. It would be in his bailiwick, and then he will conduct business as council conducts business. Now, finally, before we open it up to questions, I was a councilman, I was council president, and now I'm mayor. And so my point in telling you that is I completely know the protocol on these type of things. And that protocol is that you stay in touch with council leadership, and council leadership determines how they disseminate whatever information they have. And that is what we have done, and that's what we'll continue to do until we get it in a legislative form that is very specific so that everyone will know the specificness of the individual buckets that we talked about. Okay, any question?
Mayor, how does the incentive package compare to any that you've done previously in your tenure and beyond?
Well, it is what we do is we give incentives based, the buckets of the tools are pretty much the same. The magnitude of them in terms of dollar amount, duration of things and like that change depending on the development itself. As you know, Sherwin-Williams is an international corporation. And not only an international corporation, it was born in Cleveland and has lived here for over 150 years. So that the significance of those two things alone required us to look at this at the level of importance that we needed to look at. So this incentive package, in terms of dollar amount and in terms of duration, will be higher than I think any others that we've done that I've been mayor. I know that when I was council president and when I was a councilman, there were other kind of development activities where, again, the appropriateness of the incentive package matches the importance of whatever it is you're trying to make happen.
Mayor, the announcement today was very, sounded like finished, like a decision that the company had
yes.
made. Is there any chance that these incentives, this package that you're offering them, doesn't get approved
Well, you're absolutely right in terms of, like I say, it's just loose ends for us, but it's not tied up. In terms of the approval process, that is done through council. I can guarantee you that we will tie up our loose ends, and it will be done relatively soon. When we do that, we will talk to council leadership as to the specific nature of the specific development agreement, everything. And then we will put it in legislative form and give it to council. That is the other approval process that we cannot say for that how that will turn out. That is up to council. So we don't get ahead of council like that. We're not presumptuous like that in terms of council. I was a councilman and council president, and one of the worst things you can do is be presumptuous that what council will or will not do. I know what we're going to do, and we're going to tie it up, we're going to present it to them, and then I'm pretty sure that the council will do what it does and hold the necessary hearings and recognize what we recognize, the magnitude of this decision that has been made and the magnitude of the support that we had to put in it to have them make that decision. But it will be entirely up to council at that time.
Mayor, what hangups did the city and Sherwin-Williams run into when trying to keep the R&D facility here? Because the net jobs may actually be a loss, specifically for the city, mm-hmm. depending on what they bring. But what were those concerns? You certainly tried to keep them here.
Well, we did. And I'm not talking generalities. And you're right, the major job expansion would happen in research and development side. And one of the issues that they had to deal with and we had to deal with was the room and the ability to expand. Because you don't spend the hundreds of millions of dollars that will have to be spent for the headquarters and research, and knowing that the research component is about their future and staying ahead of the game in terms of their product and the marketing of their product, that they were not going to build to today's world knowing that tomorrow they would need additional capacity. We had a difficult time accumulating the kind of acreage that they would need to have a joint headquarters and research facility that allow for the expansion that they know they would need in the future. And so they wanted to build for the future, not just for today's product or today's market. That was a major consideration. And then where do you put them both together? And that
maybe the dreamers asked about Berkeley Front Airport.
Nobody asked about Berkeley. You know, there's a constant conversation about Berkeley, and I will always come back with the same answer. If any developer or corporation can afford to deal with environmental concerns there and what they would have to do to secure the stability of their building by doing the pilings down to whatever they had to do with do to get there, whoever can afford to do that, that means and willing to spend that kind of money means that Cleveland has gone to another level in terms of the demand for space downtown. Right now, the property has heavy environmental problems. It is not the stabilist, which means you'd have to stabilize it if you're going to construct on it. And then to get around FAA requirements about a reliever airport and all that is something that would take years, not months.
Barry, you won't get into specifics, but what are we talking about ballpark-wise? Tens of millions?
Well, it will be in the millions, yes. It will be in the millions. I will not be specific because we have to tie up loose ends, but it will be in the millions, and it will be based on the need for construction, acquisition of property. It will be based on the jobs that they retain and create. All these factors come into play, but it will be in the millions, right?
Well, if you're dividing up the pie between the state, I was guessing the county has the smallest portion and the city the largest, mm-hmm. divide it up, uh-huh. Where's the bulk of the incentives coming from?
I don't know if I would be able to say that. I know we're putting in a fair amount. I believe the state is putting in a generous amount. And as you said, the county has the smallest share in this. But the state is not slack on this. The state was very aggressive and very instrumental in communicating to Sherwin-Williams, not only did they want them to stay in Ohio, but how important it was to them that they stayed in the city of Cleveland. And they put their money where their mouth is. So I, you'd have to talk to the state about what they're putting up and how they're doing it. As you know, they have a board, and that board, they only announce their stuff once they approve something. They don't tell you what it is. Before the board approves it. They don't get ahead of the board.
Was there any other land within the city of Cleveland that they considered for research?
There were, Mr. Ripka is more familiar with that. I know that there were several sites. They had a real estate company out of Chicago.
Based out of Chicago,
who communicated with us about various sites, and all of them were downtown. Some of them, as I said, did not, all of them, as a result, all of them didn't meet the qualifications they needed to locate both facilities and have room for expansion. And then, when they kind of made that decision, they would separate them. It just became a question as well, what did they need for a headquarters? And then that became a question of what did they have to do with that particular site? Was that particular site had environmental problems? Did they have to deal something in site preparation for the stability of putting a building on it and all these other kind of things? So they wound up with this site. So yes, they looked at several sites. Some of them were distant sites that if this happened, then this would be a perfect site. And it probably would have been, but all those things you need to do to make that happen is not happening. Like whether it's the airport or lakefront or behind Tower City or things like that.
Mayor, did they ask about, raise any concerns about Hopkins International Airport? They were competing with Atlanta, which was trying to play that up pretty good.
Right.
And could there be anything that the city does to make them feel better that this airport will get growth and greater flights?
Well, you're right that, as you know, with corporations, they take airplanes like we take taxi cabs or Uber.
Uber.
Yeah.
Taxis, I haven't heard
taxis. Not in a long time. But you may take a taxi and go somewhere, or you may drive to a meeting. With corporations, they do that nationally and internationally. So having a convenient and frequent and comfortable air transportation was a primary concern of theirs. Our port director met with them. We've talked to them about our master plan and how we are attempting to use this master plan to have a more competitive for international flights or direct flights. We talked to them about the growth in travelers to and from Cleveland. Of course, that wasn't as important to them as it would be, because business people have a different mindset on how they use air transportation and the comfort and frequency and the convenience of it. So yeah, it was a concern. I think
couldn't offer any guarantees.
No, we can't offer guarantee because, as you know, the airline industry is a purely market-driven situation. It's all about, do you put people into the seats? And so, and if without doing that, there's always a discussion, then how do you underwrite the difference between putting people in the seat and what they really need to operate this particular flight to this particular location? And so for us to do that would not be feasible or affordable to us as a city. I believe the state is looking at how can they be helpful in investing not just in Cleveland's airport and helping to underwrite these kind of things, but I think there were seven major airports in the state of commercial airports in the state of Ohio. So they're looking at how can they help have Ohio be competitive based on air travel, and how do they help underwrite that, knowing that we don't have the kind of people in the seats that would cover the cost. Anybody else?
Yeah.
Yes.
The actual incentives that the council will all be public.
Yes.
There's a lot of interest in how you got here, though.
Right.
Will the workup papers, the correspondence that tells how what they wanted and how you got to where you are?
Well, anything that's public records, you're entitled to. anything that his attorney-client not entitled to, or whatever our work product is. I guess there is some restriction there. So I know y'all ask, and so we'll be prepared once we give the specifics and put it in legislative form. Then whatever it is, if you ask for a public record in regards to that, and we can share that with you, we'll gladly give it. These kind of things, are, as you know, there's always back and forth communication. There's the original thing, and then there's the final thing. And it's the negotiation and the back and forth to get from this, that to this. And so that's just a natural process. And that's why we don't do that in public. But yeah, it occurred. It occurred. But we reached a resolution, and so we're pleased with it. We're tying up the loose ends. And as I mentioned before you came in, the reason we're not introducing legislation with the specifics in it for Monday is that we have some more loose ends to tie up. And once we do that, we'll put it in legislative form, and it won't take long, put it in legislative form and send it over to council.
I thought you were talking about that, but I can't. Are you thinking perhaps the week after the holiday?
Will that soon? When is the next holiday?
You've got a meeting Monday with council, and then the next week is the holiday.
It is. Well, I don't know. I have to talk to the attorneys who are handling these agreements. We got the development agreement. We got the agreement on what you're doing. So there are people handling that. But it's close. It's close. It's close. We know that it's going to happen before summer recess. And we're going to give, and as you know, we're block grant starts this week or next week. This week.
Right.
General fund starts next week, and that's a two-week process. That doesn't stop us from introducing, but council would be tied up all of February and part of March just on budgetary stuff. So I'm pretty sure that sometime in March, they'll begin to delve into the specifics of the legislation. I'm also pretty sure that that the council president, we get over there soon enough, that he will have it routed to various committees, whether it's economic development and where else you think it would go?
Development and planning,
finance. And then we probably will have some mandatory referrals to Planning Commission, and so that's and I think they have to do that even before they hear the legislation. So there's a whole process that occurs in that.
Mayor?
Yes.
As we've been engaged in these discussions, have there been discussions with Sherwin-Williams about them possibly contributing to the Let's Save efforts that the city is engaged in? Do you believe that?
Not for me, no. I know that our discussion with Sherwin-Williams on that topic was through the Lead Safe Coalition, the initiative. And as you know, we contributed $5 million to that, and there were people in a committee of that committee who were doing the fundraiser, and I know that they were in touch with Sherwin-Williams around that. But we did not link the two, no. We are at a point of tying up a loose end, and several loose ends, and that is not one of them. There are people who took on that responsibility, knowing full well that these negotiations were going to go forward, and they took on that responsibility, and we defer to them in regards to that, I'm pretty sure they'll work something out. As a matter of fact, I know that Sherwin-Williams was one of the original people who supported the initiative, if I'm not mistaken, and participated in some of the process of coming up with what amounted to our legislation and other stuff. So there's a fundraising component of that initiative, Safe Cleveland Initiative, Lead Safe Cleveland Initiative, and we've contributed that, and we will support that. Yes.
Mayor, what other cities were you contending with in this process?
I don't know. I just stayed on Cleveland, to be honest with you. I just stayed in touch with the state and focused on Cleveland. Are you aware?
They never were specific with us.
They kept it in the air. They kept it in the air. And so we didn't ask. We didn't ask.
But I figured you'd try to find out.
No, I wasn't concerned. And because I was concerned about Cleveland and whether or not it worked in Cleveland, and with the support of the state, who, as I said, stepped up in what I consider to be a real effort to keep them in the state, that they handled that part of it, and then they. Wanted to make sure that Sherwin-Williams kept us as Cleveland on the top of their list if they stayed in the state. But I didn't ask, and I really wasn't concerned about another city. We were trying to figure out what we would do. I know traditionally what they would do, people would call around and say, what is this place offering? What is this place offering? And what is that place offering? It's like negotiating against yourself, right? And I wasn't trying to do that. We knew what we had available, we knew what our tools were, and we were in intense discussion with Sherwin-Williams, and during those discussions, we recognized that they were sincere about staying in Cleveland if we could come to an agreement. And that's what we were concerned about, not about what someone else did. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. I wonder what the city has done or is able to do as the process moves forward to ensure that this project, which is going to be on potentially a large piece of property, is going to interact with downtown and add vitality rather than being like a monolithic corporate palace.
Right. It's like having a gated community, right? And so that's why it goes to City Planning Commission. The City Planning Commission is part of that evaluation of how it fits in. They even go into materials sometimes that they use, whether or not it's a LEED standard, those kind of things. How does it fit in architecturally with the surrounding area, those kind of things. So the City Planning Commission will deal with that. We will have legislation that will not have any specifics around that, but around the incentive packages. Council then will look at what comes out of the City Planning Commission and our legislation, and then they will make a determination to support, not support, amend, whatever it might be that they do.
Are there any specific things you've asked them to do or that you hope they will do in terms of the design of this project?
I was not involved in that. I know that I don't know, in terms of the site planning, the development agreement, it doesn't address that. Is it early in the process? So you're saying there's flexibility moving forward? Okay.
Mayor, the company indicated a desire to have a positive impact on the downtown area and the surrounding neighborhood that they would be building in. So there was a recognition that it needed to be a great piece of architecture, but also something that is going to enhance the central business district.
And then I'm curious about what role the city is playing or will play going forward when it comes to talking to Sherwin-Williams about their existing facilities, because that's clearly a huge amount of company-owned real estate. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure you don't want to see that sit on the table.
Well, you know, that, again, is something that we've talked about early on in the process. If they moved, whether they stayed in Cleveland or not, what would we do with that? We talked about that, but then we began to focus on keeping them. So that, what you just mentioned is exactly, now that we've gotten over this, then we will move to that to see what would be the highest and best use. Again, I don't know what Sherwin-Williams, how they view their property, if they want to be part of a development there, or if they want to just sell it, or all these kind of things, we don't know yet. But you're right, it is a major piece on a waterfront, and would add, have a significant impact on what happens on this side of the peninsula. What's the name of the peninsula?
The north, across from Scranton Peninsula.
Scranton Peninsula. So it can help spur things moving forward, not just on this side of the peninsula, but the peninsula itself across the river. Well, I thank you very much. Thank you.